Hey, Set. Hey, Elliot. Getting set up here. Should be good. I'm trying to decide if I want to do a either just an original piece. Hey, Laura. Welcome to the stream. If I should do an original piece, or if I should just do another one of these. Kind of what do you call them? Oh, like plein airs. Hey Adam, how's it going? Welcome to the stream. I have a new webcam now. I actually have a Hey Ren Beast. I actually have a webcam now. Previously it was just like my phone acting as webcam. I'll let everyone else decide. Should we do an original or should we do high def. Plein air? Okay. We'll do a plein air. Let me find one here. Got a big list of them that Bangs got together. Oh, hey Nate. What's going on? Let's see. That one's pretty cool. Well, that's like a different color than I normally use. Ooh, a winter scene. Forest, trees, rocks. Original. Oh no, we have contrasting opinions. I could do like a mix. Like use a kind of a mix between the an original piece and something tropical. No one sent me any tropical ones. Whatever butters my biscuits. Ooh, it got postponed. Is that good that I got postponed? I'm looking at MapCrunch right now, a few things that sent my way. Fix one of your old pieces. Another original. Okay. I could do something original. Let's see. It'll probably be a temple. I did see an entrance I really liked, so maybe I'll do something like that. I could do. Your professor fanboys over me? Oh, thank you. I'm fine with that. Well, let's make sure that my. Let's see. Just want to make sure that my canvas is. Oh, it's not working. That's weird. Hang on a second here. Okay, that works. I gotta make sure my canvas is set up properly. Weird. Paint a bird? I don't know about that. Okay, I think that's working. Yeah. Also, I got a new piercing. It's the weirdest name ever. It's called the conch. It's like right inside. Let's see. I don't know. Right inside there. And I got a new stud thing for that. It's blue, surprisingly, huh? Tropical temple like a Cambodian forest. I do a tropical temple. Let's see. Want to Actually, yeah, it was probably the most painful piercing I've gotten so far. I might. Let me pull up ZBrush really quick, and I'm gonna add. Let me add that window source, window capture, because I don't want to use too much 3D, but just a tiny bit. Oops. And ZBrush.
Oops.
One second here. ZBrush. I accidentally clicked shift. I'm just gonna model just the overgrown Aztec temple. I should talk louder. I think my mic's probably too far away. How's this? Is this better? I might have it set up wrong too. Okay, let's see. I'm just gonna model like the temple entrance. And that's about it. So just really quick, I'm gonna plop a shape into the scene. And let's see. I'm just really, this is just so I don't have to spend as much time kind of just figuring out the details of this temple. I don't have to worry about the perspective if I just build it really quick like this. And you get to watch some of my 3D process. It's a bonus. So I actually use, for my 3D process, I use ZBrush mainly now. Put a bird in it. Who sent you? Did Renbeast, they tell you to come here? Say that? All this bird stuff. So let's see. Oops. Thought I had a symmetry. Yeah, I got it on now. It should be right. Nope. There we go. you just put the idea out there. Now that's what everyone wants. You're manipulating the stream, Renbeast. How dare you? So yeah, if you have any questions about kind of this process that I'm using here, I'm going to make a tutorial soon when I'm a little bit less busy. I have a few clients right now, so haven't been able to stream as much. So right now I'm just kind of coming up with a door shape design, and I want it to be kind of like it's a curve I kind of do a lot, sort of. So I'm just working with that. Oops. But I want these bits to be in a little further, and I'm going to add the curve in here. You speak for the birds everywhere. The birds! Am I loud enough now? I'll try to keep up this volume. If not, I can just turn up the volume of the, whatchamacallit. So I'm just going to bridge. Hey, Mumbles! Welcome, welcome. I'm just going to bridge these two points together. But I want them to be a little bit of a curve. So I can choose, and I'm using just my pen to kind of slide between these and decide how much of a curve I want that to be. And I could either have the door be kind of like that and have it taper up, or I could have maybe the top could be a little bit higher or something like that. And that's all right. And let's see. Okay, sounds fine now. Also, hello, Discount Daddy. I didn't see you there. How long has everyone had, like, their usernames? Are their usernames something they've carried with them from a long, long time? I used to have a different one when I was a kid, but for the most of my life, I think I've had kind of the whole... random spirits, which I'm usually known on all like Twitter and stuff like that. But I always find it interesting, like, how long have people used what they use as their usernames? I'm just gonna grab these edges here. First one was Dragoness. I read that initially as Dragon Knees, which I also like. Speaking of dragon knees, Game of Thrones had its. Mine was Silverhawk. Gah! That was from my AIM days. All the bartender headers. Mine, I think I've had mine probably for like, I don't know, 15 or 20 years, something like that now at this point. Hey, I was the original bird person. Not that I was a bird person, but I liked birds to a significant degree. Just using your name. Is there a reason that you didn't, you're not actually a bartender. My world is shattered. Let's see. Hey, just because I don't draw that many birds anymore doesn't mean I didn't do it first. So I'm just gonna do some stairs here. Anyone have some good tropical reference they can send my way? I'm kind of thinking like an Aztec temple, which I guess isn't really all that different from what I do nowadays, but. What's this? Being older is cheating. Is it though? Okay, I think that's probably good enough. So I'm just gonna throw this in perspective, and I could render it out, but I think I'm just gonna kind of choose an angle, and this angle is kind of gonna I'll paint around it. This will kind of determine the rest of the painting a little bit. I might as well give it like a stonish color or something. Sputnik art. Let's see. I'll take a quick screenshot of that. And then I'm going to go back to Photoshop. Although I'm going to have to do this using. There. Okay. So now I'm just going to throw this in here, and this is kind of my initial composition. Okay. We'll see you over in Twitch. I just want to make sure it's working. Let's see. You want to get into the weeds? What? So, what made you figure out that using a 3D animation program would be the best way to render for painting? Oh, I've just always been interested in 3D, and I've always loved 3D, so I just was like, I'll use 3D. And originally, it was just to learn. Okay, that's a good one. Originally, it was just to learn 3D, and not really to use it. Like it's the original goal wasn't like, oh, I'm gonna learn 3D to use specifically for environments. The original goal was like, I've always liked 3D, so I want to kind of try to learn that. Also, do you have a Twitch because your YouTube stream is pausing? Yeah, the Twitch is just Random Spirits. Hey, Seth, could you post those in the Discord? I have a hard time pulling them up in on Twitch because I'm not on the actually on the Twitch site. But those are all really good. I think I might have a few of those in my. Let's see. I wonder why it's stuttering. Is it, yeah, there's. Looking for a particular picture. Is the camera working better? Okay, I'm gonna draw. I'm just gonna stop messing about and start getting this drawn in here. I'm just using this kind of as per guidelines here and keeping it pretty loose. And I'll probably actually just go straight to painting in this one as well. And I like this tendency to have kind of like some straight lines like this and then curve them so you have kind of that nice contrast between lines. Camera's working good. That's good. I finally broke down and got it. Let's see. Boom, 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 boom. But yeah, I figured it, that's kind of a business expense, right? So I'm trying to think, But yeah, so that's good that it's working. This is the first time I've actually really gotten to use it. I should just have like a beard cam, get another webcam, and just have it right on my beard the whole time. That would be pretty hilarious. And now I'm just getting some of these steps kind of worn down. But let's see here. Like some jungle reference. That'd be a very fine use of time. Is anyone else having trouble logging into Twitch chat? I'm just getting a few more reference images together here. Reference is key, especially if you're working on like something you haven't really done before as much. So right now I'm looking at different plants and such. Oh, there you go. Hi. My brother said he's having problems getting on. I don't know. But yeah, today's listening is we're listening to Campfire by the River, relaxing fireplace and nature sounds, with a Robin Bird song in there for all you birdies out there. I'm such a dork. Is anyone else lagging? Oh, you know what? I wonder if Steam is downloading. Let me check. No? I'm trying to see if there's anything that might be causing it. Let me exit out of some things. Nothing really. Other than the Steam. Computer's off. Twitch is a little laggy. I'm gonna try closing some more stuff. Huh. Not terrible though. I'm sorry. Don't know why it would be lagging. It is probably cat. Kimchi's like right at my feet, being my foot warmer. Could be, isn't it? Was there any other channels that were lagging? The only thing I can think is to restart and come back, but that's always super annoying, so. And I just got all set up. See you, Ren. Thanks for stopping by. Do-do-do. So I don't know if I talked to him, if I can't remember if I had streamed before or after this. I had my work was featured on Kotaku, so that was pretty cool. One of the comments, I think it was meant to be an insult, but it was really funny. Someone was like, "Oh, I wish I could have a Cintiq to draw on like that," and then someone else was like, "Oh, all I can draw is cyan or cyan or whatever." And so I thought that was pretty hilarious. Because it's kind of true. Like, my go-to color is totally cyan. So much so. It's a little ridiculous, I suppose, sometimes. There was someone else had commented and they didn't like one of my loose pieces. And I was like, I probably shouldn't read the comments on these things. I'll just leave my career as an artist over one comment. Let's see. Maybe some kind of jungly tree type things here. Use these as some framing devices. Maybe a bigger one over here. Yeah, it was really cool. Wrong pen here. Yeah, I was like, I'll just walk away. There's no point. Yeah, I've had a few pieces on there. I want to do one of those. They finally implemented, you can have 360 paintings in there natively now. So I kind of really want to try one of those. That looks like a lot of fun. But we'll see. Wait, oh. I'm sorry, I have all my audio turned off, so I probably didn't hear. Did someone follow me? Where is. Oh, it's still going. I had it turned way down, so I didn't hear anything, but I really appreciate the follow. Thank you. Thank you, thank you. I'm just gonna put some big leafy stuff in the front here. And so compositionally, like, I could have the stairs kind of running off this way, but I like bringing them back a little bit this way near the end. I have enough of this off that. I don't really need any more. I might grab this last kind of perspective off these stairs here. And I can always turn this layer back on a little bit later. But this time I just want to use a little bit of 3D just to kind of, have a little helping hand. Haven't really seen people depicted in your art, or do you focus mainly? Yeah, I just focus on landscapes. I'm pretty much just an environment artist. It's what I enjoy the most. And it keeps me busy. I do like doing props as well, which is very similar to environments, really. Let me get this little piece here. And could have maybe like a pillar or something off in the distance. Or this could be like a broken wall or something there. Or a cloud. We'll figure that out as we go. Do you keep a sketchbook for study plant life to depict? I do have a sketchbook that I draw on a lot, but usually my sketchbook's more for just ideations and stuff, just kind of doodling, It's more of a, if I'm away from my computer, I'll use it. But if I'm at my computer, I'll just use my computer to do sketching and stuff. Or if I just want a break from sitting on my butt for so long, I'll go sit on my butt somewhere else and sketch. Or if I'm at, like, hanging out with people, sometimes I'll ignore them. Not on purpose, but just to get some practice in. But mainly I do use a lot of reference. Like right now I'm referencing just, I got a bunch of jungle scenes here. I've got some Studio Ghibli art over here. Just kind of looking at colors and all different things like that. Like if I do a kind of a painting that's sort of like all my other paintings, it usually, I don't really need reference because I have all of that in my mind for the most part already. But if I start implementing somewhat new ideas and stuff like that, I'll always, before I start a project, I'll just go and collect a bunch of reference and start going around and just make a big bulk thing of it. And I use, the program I use is Pure, it's either POR ref or PURE. Not sure which one it is, but it's a really fantastic program. You can make like a big, you can compile a big sheet of reference and put it together in there. And then once you have that, you can save it out. So you could, like, I'll have just a big thing of Viking reference with all kinds of Viking ruins and Viking, I'll say, yeah, there it is. Like Viking engravings and things like that. Just stuff that I might not, be able to just pull out of my head without having seen it in a while or something like that. So I haven't really decided anything as far as lighting goes yet in this piece. So I probably should think about that pretty soon. And most likely I'll just, I think I might bring this across here. And just have a bit of a broken wall. So when I'm doing lighting, I'm thinking of different compositional reasoning for my lighting, like how it will help compose the scene to be a little more interesting than if the lighting wasn't there, or if the lighting was just straight above, or things like that. But yeah. Oh, another thing I don't know if I mentioned, I beat Zelda. I probably mentioned this last time. I don't know if I'd beaten it at that point though. But I beat Zelda Breath of the Wild. Well, I beat the final boss. There's a lot more I could do in the game. It's a very cool game. Has everyone else out there played it? I'm not going to talk about any of the spoilers or anything like that because I feel like that game is best experienced without knowing anything about it. Oh yeah, I played all the Uncharted games. They're really beautiful. Although I didn't play the Golden Abyss. I mean, I played a little bit of it, but I don't own a system that can play it. And hi, Lion the Emu. I'm glad you made it to the live stream. Thanks for joining. And gotta find all the Koroks. I think I have like 100 and something of them. And those are all like, I'm not like seeking them out, but if I ever see like a little interesting area that I'm like, ooh, that could be a Korok, I'll definitely try to solve the little mystery or whatever. Some of them are really, really simple, so it's not too difficult. Let's flip this a little really quick here. I think it's maybe no. There we go. Yeah. I'm gonna flip that just to make sure things are looking good. And so what I might do over here is just have like a little bit of breathing room, and maybe just like a hint of a some sort of temple shape or something in the background. Might be interesting. But yeah. So Lion, have you seen some of the not live versions of my videos? The tutorials and such? I'll put another one. Kind of this temple shape way in the background here. Zelda Brothers! Hey! How's it going, man? Welcome to the stream. Didn't you start streaming recently, Zelda Brothers? I believe you. I have yet to catch your stream. There we go. And then we're gonna have, you know, some of these crumbling back and stuff like that. But I think that's probably enough, and then I'll have some, you know, some vines grouping here and there. And let's see. Some kind of generic foliage here. And a lot of this I'll probably end up painting over a lot of these lines, but they're giving me a good idea of what's there. I kind of want like one of those really nice ferny kind of spiky plants right here. There's going to be so much green in this, you'll be so happy. Trying to think, we could do like I think the weapons of like the Mayans, they use these things. They look a lot like croquet, or not croquet, cricket bats. They look a lot like cricket bats. They kind of, I believe they're like this shape, and then they would have like just chunks of metal and stuff embedded into them. There was another weapon they had that they could like throw stuff. It was like a, I think it was like a long, almost like a dog ball thrower thing that you can get. Except I think it was for throwing rocks and such. Okay, and let's see. Maybe there's a hint of a old torch or something right here. Maybe it had like one of the, yeah, we'll have it still attached. There we go. It's funny, I guess it's jungly, but it still kind of looks like a lot of my other stuff. But I guess that's because I drew it, so that's bound to happen. Okay. Yep, exactly. Yeah, this thing's look. Those are pretty brutal looking. I forgot what they're called, though. But they're really interesting. So then, there's a few ways you can approach putting color in a piece like this. You could just start straight painting it in. Or sometimes what I like to do is I'll go and just grab one of my own paintings and just throw that in the background. We need some birds. I'll get Renbees to paint some in. If I have time, I'll try painting some in. So I could take like one of my old pieces, like this one right here. Has a nice appropriate color palette. And then I'll just grab it and blur it just like a ton. And then maybe I'll grab it and just alter it some more. I'll put some, so I could shift into the greens a bit more, go a little more yellow, and kind of get a good general idea of some of the coloring. Could go more, a little more blue. That's kind of interesting. We'll go a little more on the yellow end. So now we already have like a decent value structure. I could, you know, move this around a little bit. I could look at my other paintings and see if there's anything else that I want to grab and just toss in there as texture reference or something. This one might have some cool, this is an older one I did. Might have some cool texture in there. I'm just gonna grab this piece of texture here. I don't always do this, but I thought it'd be kind of an interesting way to show some process ideas here. So now I can just start doodling that in there. I already have some colors, don't have to think about things too much. I'm still thinking, but you know, that's a lot easier than kind of picking out just a plain color and going from there. All we need is birds, birds, birds. All we need is birds. But yeah, this automatically gives me a good amount of color. I use a large mix of brushes. I have some of them on my Patreon for free. They just happen to be linked there. My Patreon is currently kind of inactive, but totally inactive. They're pretty basic brushes, but I also use a few. I just recently incorporated a few from some different artists. One of them being Jeremy Fenske. I believe that's how you say his name. And if you look him up, it's just Jeremy, and then his last name is spelled, let's see, Fens, it's something like that. Super talented guy, and he shared his brushes. And I probably could just find him. Here, I'll just find his link. So I used some of his, and let's see if I can find him. There he is. Yeah, so here's the other brushes. And he has like a Gumroad, you can download his brushes. So I have a few of his in my pack, like this one right here, the square one I'm using. That one's one of his. And I have some other brushes from another artist, but I can't remember his name off the top of my head because it's a very difficult to pronounce name. I believe he's like Russian or something. But yeah, I think actually, I don't know if I was already following him a while back, but he did like this really fantastic Zelda fan art piece. And I was like, this is really cool. So I started watching his streams and stuff. And he's a cool dude. Well, I already have a decent amount of the painting in place. So now I just have to start coming up with... yeah, I think that might be it. I listed them in... Actually, you know what? I could easily find it. Because I just started using them maybe like just a few paintings ago. And I think... Was it this painting? Nope, wasn't that one. No. I just used them recently. Oh, it was in this. Yeah. If you go to this painting, no, it's like Gzorgz, Grzegorz. His last name's Rutkowski. But yeah, I used some of his brushes, and I kind of implemented them into my pack of brushes that I use. So I'll probably put out a new, since all the brushes I am using, they are all from... like they're just giving out for free, and I give out the ones I've made for free or the ones I've collected over the years. And this is actually one of his brushes. It kind of has like a really kind of splattery look to it. I really like it. And right now I'm trying to figure out what color this tree will be. Maybe it'll be kind of like a whitish something. And some of my brushes, like this one, is just like it's the default chalk brush from Photoshop, so it's really nothing terribly unique about it. Really, I know there's lots of artists that just use the round brush, and that's what I use to draw. Like all my lines are just usually just round brush. This is the default round. With maybe like transfer and shape dynamics turned on. Really, the brush's main purpose usually ends up just being getting a little bit more texture into the painting. Because usually that's the harder thing about working digitally is you just have a harder time getting any kind of texture in there without many brushes. And there's this square brush. I think this is also from the guy's name who I can't pronounce, and I'm sorry for that. Could do for this background, we could do like maybe something out of the blue spectrum, but I'll probably end up going a little bit blue. Maybe I'll do like a. That's kind of nice. Kind of like this kind of almost foggy sort of coloring. A lot of haze in the air and things like that. Yeah, something like that could work. And I'll just keep things kind of loose for now back there. And I can paint out that background as I go. And right now my lines are still just like there's black. I could set them to like a color. So I'll grab my lines a lot of times and just start applying a color to them. I have them all on overlay, but if you kind of crank up the, say, colorize. Crank up the saturation a little bit, and then you can choose maybe give them like a little bit of a, in this case, like a bit of a green hue would be pretty apt for the setting. And we'll set that to maybe multiply. And you can just lighten them up until they feel like they're kind of starting to blend with the scene a little bit better. Oh, I set them to color burn or something by accident. Let me go back in here and make them a little darker, a little more saturated. Yeah, there we go. So now we can kind of just start a. Hang on here. Someone's messaging me. There we go. So now I can start relying on the lines a little less. It's always good to kind of get away from your lines a little bit early on if you can. But sometimes it's hard to do that. Okay. So I don't have a distinct direction for the lighting yet. I think I might do that right now. And the way I'm going to do that, I'm going to actually just kind of select areas that I want to be hit by the light. And just selecting these kind of front areas. Yeah. And I love using the lasso tool. I used to use a lot more, and I kind of want to start using it more again. It's just a really great tool to get a lot of stuff done really fast. And it just lets you really hit areas with color and light and things like that really fast. So there's a few ways I can do this. I have that selected still, I just hit Control H to hide it. And I could go in here and do like a color dodge or something just to get some light hitting that. That's actually kind of nice. It's giving me a little bit of a little more color to the area. Having the stone pop out a little bit more. I could take that and shift the color to see if I want it to be a little more green, maybe a little more yellow. But see how that quick selection is giving me a lot of lighting information that I didn't have before. But this area would also, I'm just gonna make a new layer, be hit over here with that lighting. So now that I have the lighting color, I can kind of just
paint it in as I go.
I have a little more idea of which how things will turn out now. But yeah. And then same thing here, like this area in shadow, I just want to make that a bit more distinct. So I could do a new layer, do like a overlay, and just start kind of casting stuff into shadow a bit more. And I can even just use that just to kind of, we'll get a little more green glow there. I can grab colors and sort of overlay them onto areas so they get a little bit more of that feeling, or more of the feeling I'm looking for. Yeah. Getting close to be able to paint, be ready to paint over the lines. I'm gonna grab, I think it's this brush. And here we're just gonna, oh, too dark. I'm gonna paint some color in behind right here just to kind of be where the path is gonna be. A few stones I missed and things like that. Don't leave any stones unturned. Yeah. So does anyone have any cool plans this weekend? Is there any holidays coming up? I don't even remember now. And I'm gonna grab like kind of a brown, green brown color here. Get a little of that mixed in here as well. Ooh, hardcore mode. Is that like, what's the difference in that mode? I'm guessing Fallout 4. I haven't played Fallout 4 yet. I've only played, I played a tiny bit of 2 and 1, but mainly I played 3 was the big one for me. Oh my gosh, so you're just dead and you're gone? Can you save it? Is there like a kind of romance? Are you playing Andromeda set? Hey Zoologico, how's it going? Oh man, it's been a long time. Things are going good for me. Well, yeah, I'd say they're good. Has some ups and downs, but overall, I'd say everything's going well. Oh, man. You can, but that's not. Going to be doing a Photoshop project for Professor. Oh, hey, Professor McDonald's. So you're how many people are actually in here from your professor's class? Oh, when you said the professor thing, you were talking about. I know who you're talking about now. I didn't even think about. I forgot about that. Oh my god. Where is my? So you're going to be doing, what was it, you're doing Photoshop project? What do you have to do for your Photoshop project? Is he in here watching you? Keeping an eye on you? I was almost a professor there. Very close. So many students. You have to create a poster for our company, either photo manipulation or painting. Oh. is like a made up company, or is it kind of like your art company that you would be part of or something? I'm going to start painting over stuff now. This is where the fun begins. West of nine. Patented. Is it patented or is that patent pending? Runs out and gets the patent on it. Cool. Sounds like fun. A situation like that, I think for me it would be so hard to come up with a company name. Oh yeah, doesn't this count as like a field trip for you guys? Getting all those ginger snaps. You can use them to win. The current game is, I think, Jotan. But yeah, you can use them to win stuff in the stream. Yeah, you can just gamble them. It's nothing. The Science Mouse. Hey, that's a good name. Yeah, pretty much just always listen to Set. He always knows better than I. What's going on most times? Gambling. Let's see, where is multiply normal? I'm just gonna clean that up a little bit so it's a little easier to see what's going on. Hey, how's it going, Ronan? Welcome back. Winner, winner, chicken dinner. Gotta be pretty late there for you, isn't it? Do-do-do-do. All or nothing. I'm doing pretty good. Just working. Well, I guess not working. This is my break from working. I'm self-employed. Get it. Yeah, I play at nighttime. I'm about to fall asleep. Then I play Zelda. Oh, thank you. I appreciate it. Trying to keep it a little bit looser this time around. You're a winner now. What will you do with all your winnings? Oh, thanks. Yeah, the hot poster turned out really. That was a lot of fun to work on. It was one of the more fun projects I've had in a while. It turned out really nice. And there was a bunch of other really great artists that were working on them too. Flip this. Let's see here. Do. Yeah, I want to do a little bit more blue. Just gonna throw in some loose blue stuff back here. What's ticket supposed to do? Get some background stuff going on here. Just a stream of ginger snap stuff happening. Winning all the loot. I kind of don't like this tree on this side here. I might just paint it out. About to do the drawing. We could do the drawing at the end of the stream if I remember. That's usually the only thing stopping it from happening is not remembering. Does anyone have any field trip questions? See, now maybe we'll have, instead of just the full tree, we could just have some vines running down here. I started using a new brush for clouds. Which one was it? Maybe it was this one. No, it wasn't that one. It was. Which one was this one? How often do I practice? Hey, beautiful union. Wait, beautiful onion. How's it going? I practice. I guess it depends on what you call practice. Like, how often do I paint? How often do I work? Like, kind of everything's practice, I guess, in some regards. I'm doing good. Thanks for asking. I guess it really depends, because right before this, I was just doing freelance, so I stopped and took a break to do this. So you could say that's kind of like I was practicing by working, I guess. I don't know. You could look at that either way. This is looking really messy. Ugh. Don't get caught up using too many layers. Like, I'm using a lot of layers right now, but they're really kind of inconsequential. Like, I could just flatten the whole piece and just work on one piece. I'm kind of just using layers to just kind of keep sort of a history of the painting, I suppose you could say. Another word of advice, don't spend all your time looking for the perfect brush. It doesn't really doesn't really exist. Like there, you can do a great painting with pretty much any brush. It does. You just have to paint. So make sure and don't get caught up looking for that perfect brush, but just paint with what you have, and I think you'll do a lot better. Don't worry too much about. Presser tool has never used eraser tool, or what's your opinion on that? I mean, I wouldn't say never, but if you're going for a more painterly look, the less you use your eraser, the more painterly it's going to look. But hang on, was it beautiful? You did a painting last day, really inspired in your work. Aw, thank you. I'm glad I'm an inspiration for you. That means a lot. I've had countless inspirations from other people as well, so it's always heartwarming to hear that. Thank you. I would say the not using your eraser thing is like I use an eraser. I don't use it a ton. When I'm drawing, I use it a lot, I guess, but still not even a ton. I mean, it's good to challenge yourself not to use the eraser. And maybe just starting out, maybe it'd be, yeah, totally, you can link it. Yeah. But yeah, starting out, maybe it's a good idea to try relying less on that. Because the eraser kind of, you know, the undo button and stuff like that. It's always good to test yourself and try not to use some of the features of Photoshop and try using it as its most basic function. Griffin, I'm not sure. I'd probably try to finish this painting. Yeah, other than that, I don't really know. I'll probably be on for another hour or so. Let's see. Oh, cool. That looks really nice. My only suggestion would be is if you can push further than what the renders has there for you. But I like it. It's really cute. It's nice to listen to you and see some work. I'm gonna go get free food. Well, enjoy that free food. Ah, thanks, Griffin. I appreciate it. Hopefully you can make it back in time. Yeah, nice work. Nice work on this. I see you did like the 3D base. You got the, what's it say on your cup? Your Starbucks cup. Taking a look at it right now. I like the butterflies flying around. I'd maybe have one butterfly like that's bigger and closer to the camera. That's really cool. You got a little Pokeball in the back there. I like all your little hidden bits surrounding it. Nice work. Yeah, feel free to share artwork and stuff in here. Just you know, keep it friendly. Or appropriate, or whatever you might want to say. Let's see, I'm going to do another. I think. I don't really like my lighting in here. I'm gonna do another. Looks a little messy, I guess. Oops. Well, other advice is also don't get discouraged because every artist has things that just don't turn out well. It just happens. I just want something a little more interesting in the lighting. Yeah, I was just getting really flat looking up there. So this is a little bit better. I could do a little bit of color variety on this. That's a bit better. I'm gonna use my chalk brush for a little bit. My lasso tool always helpful. I'm just gonna get some blue in there. Just get some more color. Where is that brush? I recently tried to organize my brushes a bit better, so they're all a bit in new spots for me, but they're a little more organized, so that's good. Trying to keep this loose without getting lost. That can always be difficult. It's always a little scary when you start removing your lines. Kind of a little lost in my own painting, but it happens. I think I just don't have as direct of a lighting situation as I would like, or as clear. Some things are pretty ambiguous. Nothing yet. I haven't really thought of anything yet for it. Too busy trying to get it to look correct first. I haven't had enough time to kind of relax on the piece and actually think about it a bit more. Once I get kind of a break from the work part of painting it, maybe I can come up with something. Just trying to clear things up on it right now. Maybe a new perspective. I might flip it again. That always helps. Well, things are looking a little wonky here and there. Yeah, my perspective a little bit wonky. I'll have to fix that at some point. Yeah, let's see, where are we now? Got more information here. Sorry, I went all quiet. I guess I'm thinking. Sorry, that thing where I start off early and talking a lot and doing well in the talking front. And then I start fading. I think I just get tired. I don't know how people do like the super long streams for like 8 hours and such. It's crazy. It's looking a little bit better. Maybe I'll put some no social life. Can't see my keyboard. There we go. My social life's hanging out with my cats. Actually, I went out and saw people in the real world just yesterday. Let's do a little bit of banana brush. There it is. I don't know about this yellow. I have such an inclination to put a little bit of blue in there. What's the real world? What's real world, precious? The real world with outside. Well, I just used the eraser. Thanks. I said something different. I don't normally do that. The forbidden erase. Yes. Yeah, I was just seeing if it looked better at different croppings. The forbidden erase. Okay, let's see. Gotta get some texture in here. That is one thing with painting without like 3D bases and stuff. You end up painting over a lot of stuff, just getting rid of lines, getting rid of things, stuff like that. Was something I was looking at earlier. What was that? Gotta break that edge up a little bit so it's not quite so consistent. It's come along. Things are looking like things. Oops, I changed up my pattern from one side to the other. Best to keep that consistent. Is Ghost in the Shell out yet? Has anyone seen that? I don't think it's out yet. I don't remember. Maybe it is. Oh, it is out. Wow. I have not yet seen it. Originally, I didn't want to, but now I kind of want to just because some of the art looked really cool. Let's see. There was a pattern I saw earlier. Where did I see that? Yeah, I thought I had like a pattern reference. 50. Oof. That's pretty bad though, isn't it? It seems like they maybe took it in a bad direction, huh? I kind of want to just see it for the visuals, really, though. I need a better consistent pattern. Oh my God, really? I was really surprised that one actor was in Assassin's Creed. Like, what was he thinking? Yeah, Fassbender shirtless couldn't save it. What was he doing in that movie? I don't understand why he was even in there. This seems like a bad call. Yeah, I suppose we all do those gigs. We don't want to sometimes. I never really thought Assassin's Creed had the greatest of stories, though. But I guess they are pretty popular. Popular. Everybody needs some paychecks sometimes. Played a few of them, like the characters, but lost interest. Yeah, I played a few of them too. I lost interest really fast, though. Like, I feel like the first one kind of had all it had to offer, really, except the quests were very repetitive. And they kind of fixed that, but then they just sort of. Oops. I guess it did have some interesting characters. Oh yeah, Leonardo da Vinci was a fun character. Historical fanfic. True. It was pretty cool. The oldest of fan fiction, historical fan fiction. Do, do. Like my brush isn't quite. Maybe it's the flow? I thought I had flow turned off though. Weird. A few more rubble bits. Anyone else run into the issue where there's like you have Netflix, you have so much to watch, you just end up watching the same thing you've already watched before? I do that a lot. Hey, the Science Mouse. Thanks for the follow. For instance, I have watched Always Sunny and, Star Trek: The Next Generation so many times. Don't feel like getting invested in new stories. Yeah, that's the thing. Like, I usually just like. Yeah, Science Mouse, thanks a lot for the follow. But yeah, I always just end up rewatching those. Like, I was watching Always Sunny last night and watching, TNG today. It's like, oh. It's just, I guess, one of those shows. Yeah, Always Sunny is gold. It's so funny. I think I've talked about it before, but it always took me a long time to get into it when I first started watching it. Hotel. Huh? I haven't even heard of that. What's that? Broad Church? I don't know what that is either. You're speaking a different language to me, Set. Murder mystery? Okay. I usually don't get too into murder mysteries. Oh, okay. It did sound very British. It's a Broad City spin-off. If I have like a leafy brush. Probably a generic leafy brush in here somewhere. Color dynamics and hue jitter. Little bit of value jitter. That's kind of cool. Maybe value jitter. Brightness jitter is a little bit less. I kind of like that one. Yeah, so sorry. It's like the majority of TV shows, too. See, I'm gonna do a little I haven't seen Bangs too much since he got his job. What's he doing? Working? What a jerk. How dare he work? I know, right? Oh, wow. That was amazing timing. That's funny. That's too funny. Hey,
Hey, Bags. That is absurd timing. He must have just been waiting there for someone to say something, and they're like, ha, that's my time, that's my cue. Hey Jordan, thank you. I appreciate it. Coming along. Slowly but steadily. It's building up layers on top of layers. Yeah, I'm gonna do more vines once I get kind of the base coat down. If I do them now, I'll just have to paint over them. But good call, good call. That was pretty creepy, Bangs. Pretty creepy. Needs more teal. I have a large lacking of blue in here, don't I? I really blew it with this painting. Yeah, I don't know. I have not figured that out yet. It's a lot of green. Hey, J.R. Bogart. Thanks for the follow. Maybe some little blue plants here. Yeah, I don't know. Right now, I just got to get the get this all this in here. Bioluminescence incoming. No, you know me too well. Am I that predictable? I kind of am. And a piece from a reference would have been a lot easier. Big flowery vines would be a good way.
Yeah, I want to do big leafy vines and stuff. I could, yeah, putting flowers on the vines is a really good idea. I won't be ignorant. I'm gonna use that idea. Hey, how's it going? Oh no. Gonna see me use your brushes. Thanks for joining the stream. Got a bit of a mess here, but it's starting to come together. Oh, thank you. You're too kind. Everyone should check out J-Air Art stream. That's what I was just talking about earlier. I'm using some of his brushes over here. And yeah, here. I will post it in chat. And you should definitely follow him for some wonderful painting characters, environments. And yeah. He seems like a cool dude. I would highly recommend following him. Think you just started your streaming recently, right? No problem. Actually, I already sent people your art station earlier for your brushes. How are you liking streaming so far? Well, a couple weeks. Wow. I'll see you, Josh. Yeah, I might be around later tonight. I have to do some freelance stuff, so I'll probably be up late working on that. Ooh, yeah, that'd be a nice color to add. Yeah, that's true for editing. I tend to, when I post like tutorial videos and stuff, it's I don't really edit stuff out. I kind of just I plan what I'm gonna do, and so I just go from there. Which probably not the most professional way to do it, but it works. I usually just kind of edit an intro and stuff in there and go from there. Oops, wrong button. Like an hour and something, I think. Like an hour and a half, maybe? I'm not really sure. There you go, hour and 47 minutes. I was kind of unsure where to take this one for a while. It's starting to come together, but I'm still kind of like, eh. I always get the streaming jitters once in a while. Oh, hey. Hey, hypnotizing. How's it going? Thanks for stopping by. You love failing in front of people? Yeah. I guess maybe that's what keeps me coming back too. It's just like, I used to be horrible at speaking in front of people. So I just started throwing myself in situations where I had to speak in front of people, and I was like, well, I guess this is the best way to learn this. And it seems to work. If you like failing in front of people, streaming is perfect then. Did you get a chance to finish your thanks, hypnotizing. Did you get a chance to finish your Dead Space painting? Oh my gosh, forearms. That sounds intense. On the blog, did you post it on ArtStation or just your blog? I didn't know people still use Blogspot. Oh, cool. Not our station worthy. I just put like a sketches page. I like the rain and stuff you added. Hey Charlie, thanks for the follow. Appreciate it. I'm just giving you a hard time. Sort of. I'd hate to pull up my Blogspot, have probably some really old, terrible, terrible work on it. Actually, this is the first day I have my a real legitimate webcam. Before I was using just my phone. Oh, it's always nice seeing people's terrible art. I think I did a stream where I pulled up a bunch of my old, just really, really bad art. Nowadays, I tend to post most stuff even just on my ArtStation if it's good or bad. Let's see. I don't think I've taken any. Should probably look into some of those classes on CGMA. I'm really bad about taking courses and classes, but they'd help so much, though, for sure. Make it some of like that kind of blue white moss in some of these spots here. Think that's kind of the color for that, and then like you kind of have that those greens. That's a little too much there. I did do a little bit of schoolism with, I think I bought one class from Nathan Foulkes. That was super good for his color. I think it was color and light or something with color. That guy's art's really, really good. Do a little bit of like a hue jitter brush in here. Oh, cool. Did you live in China or were you just visiting, Jeremy? Norwegian death metal. That's very specific. Oops. Oh yeah, you mentioned that in stream. That's cool. I have not gotten a chance to really go out of the States other than Canada. Thanks for stopping by, man. I appreciate it. I'll have to try catching your stream. You stream on Wednesdays, right?
see here. Get a little bit of. Cool, I'll have to try checking out your Wednesday streams. I guess Sundays would probably work for me too. Ah. Just gonna do this. Is anyone working on some art they can share? Wouldn't mind seeing some works. Thought about doing some gaming streams. I've played games on here. I don't know how I would stream Zelda though. Otherwise, I would be streaming Zelda. Like, I would love to stream Breath of the Wild, but I don't have any of the proper tools to do so. You probably need like a, I don't know what you need. Gotta get a capture card? Yeah. I guess I won't be streaming any Breath of the Wild then. No, I didn't get, I'm just playing on the Wii U. See, what side was I gonna do? I'm gonna go back look at my drawing to see what I was gonna do. Nope, wrong layer. Somewhere in here. There it is. So I think I'm going to do kind of these large a new version of Switch. Is it going to be more powerful or something? Or let's see. Excuse me. Yeah, until it has more games and I have more money, then maybe I'd buy it, but right now.
Oh, they did it for the 3DS Switch. Yeah, they'll probably do that for the Switch as well. Hang on just one second. I'm streaming right now. Are you getting something? Are you picking stuff up or? Could go to Zoe's. Or get pizza. Okay. That sounds good. Okay. Love you. Do you see the video with all the problems that I had to get? Is that the what it screams at you? Oh, its characters come along really nicely, Zoo. Looks cool. Yeah, good seeing you too. Are you gonna get we should talk on the webcam or something sometime. Words. See, hypnotize. Are you heading out hypnotizing? Bye, Charlie. Okay, see you later. Good seeing you. Oh, did you, Clinty, did you change your name? I haven't been streaming in a while either, so I understand that. Yeah, I didn't realize it was you. Yeah, I remember Clinty, I just didn't know it was you. How's it going, man? Total Eclipse, thanks for the follow. I appreciate it. Welcome to the stream. If you have any questions, feel free to ask. Ba-da-ba-doo. Yeah, I've been busy. I just hadn't had a chance to stream it. Usually when I disappear, it's not because I stopped art. It's just because I have too much art to do and I can't show any of it. Cool. Well, I'm glad you're enjoying it. Do-do-do. This is just layers and layers of building up foliage and stuff. So much stuff. wonder if I have like a. I think I made one a long time ago. I had a fern brush. Oh, it was a lifesaver. Make one right up here really quick. Kind of just that fern leaf look. Honestly, I could probably just use not even a brush, just kind of. Just gonna throw these, a few of these here and there. Maybe bend them a little bit. Ooh, you know what I could do? I could stream the new Dark Souls DLC if anyone's interested in watching that. That'd be kind of fun. Throw a few of these here and there. I do die a lot. Maybe I'll do that really quick if I have some time, if I finish this painting fast enough. Because, yeah, that's pretty funny. Okay, what was my line? I'm gonna do this a little differently. My line work originally had me doing like the smaller leaves on the left or on the right, but I'm gonna do the opposite of that because I think compositionally it just make more sense. Yeah, sure. Do you want like a hardcore critique or what are you looking for? It's probably the most jungly piece I've ever done. Okay. Oh, nice. For 1 year experience, you're doing really well. I would do more atmosphere to separate out the like the background behind the wire gate and everything. Let's see. Maybe brighten up the wolf a bit or something. No, not to brighten up. He seems a little bright on the front. He seems like he'd have more rim lighting. I'm just looking at a smaller version of it though. But yeah, more rim lighting, and I would say like your trees look a little like fuzzy, like clouds. So maybe give them a little more, like think when I do trees, I do kind of chunks, but then I also do kind of little bits hanging off of them like that. I may put a few small stones and things like that on the path just to kind of break that up a little bit. Looks good though. Good job. For your experience, you're doing great. Just keep it up and you'll be fine. It's really all it is just about keeping up with the work. You're very welcome. Really, all you have to do is just be dedicated, be willing to take critiques, and just keep pushing yourself, and you'll be a great artist. And don't get down on yourself. Like pretty much all any painting and stuff, you always end up. Even when you're been doing it for years and years, you still have turds. I know this painting was early in the process here. It was actually kind of pretty frustrating for me, but I think I got it to a spot where I'm starting to like it now. But it takes a while sometimes. You'll have a painting that just don't like. One thing I'm noticing is this piece is just too small. Always be willing to change, composition things and like as you paint, and never settle for something. So always push yourself to go better, further, stronger, faster. And yeah, there is that giveaway. If anyone wants, I believe it's Jotan. It's a really cool looking 2D game, it'd be a Steam key. So if anyone wants that, feel free to use your like your time here. You get ginger snaps, and you can use those to put into the giveaway. I used to work somewhere as an artist. Now I am a freelance artist. So,
it's raining beards.
Where did that come from? I must have something set up that says that. But yeah, now I'm just a freelance artist doing the same stuff, just working from home. I don't know what. Oh, maybe because you said giveaway? No, I don't know how that happened. I don't know where. I think someone must have. Someone wants to redeem. I forgot that he would existed. I was so confused. I'm the one that set it up.
I don't know what that says about me. It kind of scared me. No, don't spend it on X-Files. I don't know if X-Files is set up anymore, Seth. I kind of hope it isn't. You can, if it didn't kick off, you could have the ability to redeem stuff, right? Or not redeem, but get points back and stuff. Yeah, hey, go ahead and refund that. You can refund Clinty too. I should probably go in there and remove those. Excuse me. Okay, see you, Total Eclipse. Thanks for stopping by. I appreciate you hanging out with us. Bye. Do you want to see the new trailer for the It movie or teaser? Ooh, that's a good idea. A happy pile of offerings. Yeah, a little bit. It had Finn Wolfhard or Wolfhard in it from what's that show called? Stranger Things. I think we're just becoming old people. Hey, Leonardo, welcome back. Hey, little yellow submarine. Yeah, they can be. Sometimes they can be stressful too. It does seem like that's the goal, is the But I never actually saw the original. I haven't watched too many Stephen King things or read too many of them. Oh, is Tim Curry is he it? Tim Curry's pretty good. Yeah, the bird sounds and stuff definitely make it more relaxing, huh?
It's starting to get there. There was a picture way up here that I liked that someone posted. See if I can find it really quick. There we go. Let's see. Akira movie. Just got a Ghost in the Shell movie. What was the Rotten Tomato score again? Like 70 something? It's actually not that bad if that's what it is. That's oh, 50. That's a lot worse. Gets a 50. I suppose considering what's going against, it's not too terrible. Yeah, kind of. I think Ghost in the Shell, the visuals are kind of what really got me, even the old one, like the visuals, and yeah, the sound was really good too. I remember when I was really little, when I first watched, I was like, I don't know what any of this means, but I like it. Like the kind of the story went over my head quite a bit. Yeah. Too slow for a kiddo like you. I used to be able to stay awake for any kind of movie. Honestly, nowadays I have a hard time staying awake for stuff. Although I did watch, it's not a happy movie at all, but it was based on true stories. It was called Devil's Knot. Oh my God. That one was super good. Very upsetting, but you watch Devil's Knot? Oh my God. It was really good, but very upsetting. Oh God, I couldn't finish it. I couldn't watch Rubber. I tried. He fell in love instantly. Oh. To each his own. To each his own. Was one of the most boring movies I've watched in a long time. Was definitely unique, though. I'll give it that. Excuse me. I had. What happened to my vines? Didn't I have more vines at one point? Oh. So many hiccups today. Yeah, I couldn't watch it because I think I got really bored. I thought I had some in here, like kind of like right there. Maybe not. There we go. Where's that brush? I keep hitting the wrong key. Control H, there we go. Ooh, I want to watch that too. I never really watched the old one that much, but the new one looks so good. I wonder if you have to see the old one to kind of keep up with it.
I don't know. Did it get canceled? Did it even actually end? I don't really know what happened to that. Yeah. We'll never know. They did a lot of cool stuff in that. The animation was really nice. Wasn't that one of the same animators that did like Clone Wars or something? Like the 2D ones? Thanks, Zoologic. Take care. Have a good night. Yeah, the art style was super cool. Oh, hey James. Once I'm done streaming, or actually now you should be able to just like rewind all the way to the beginning and just watch through it, I believe. So yeah, it'll once I'm done streaming, it'll should automatically go up there. Pretty sure you can rewind while you're if you wanna not be live. That's weird. If that's the case, I will export the Twitch version.
That usually has the whole version. So in like the pattern, I'm just gonna do an old pattern that I've done a long time ago. Yeah, I'll check. Just make sure and check back later. It should be up there at some point. Yeah, that looks cooler. I just like that pattern better. It's just random spirits as a username. Well, Seth's always there to save the day. I think they're on YouTube already. At least your name matches. It's always something that caused the downfall of something.
Might be restream. It is very likely that restream is messing up. Oh, really? Oh, that's too bad. I thought, is the Twitch creative section dying? I usually try to make sure and switch over when I switch between painting and not painting. Let's see. I'll do a little bit of a little bit of banana sphere, aka atmosphere. Kind of want like that little bit of a kind of hazy look. Banana time. Everything's just a game, according to Twitch. The bloom is real.
Really? Wow. Didn't know they were so hardcore about that stuff. The old days of Twitch, huh? How'd they even figure out what to ban and what not to ban? That seems crazy. Welcome home, Megan. Well, this is timing out pretty perfectly. Motion blur. Megan just got home. Blade did not work out. Let me try that again. Okay, almost done. Don't think you'll die. Set says hello. Set. Megan says hi. It's right here, you can say hi. You'd be in high def. You could say that there's a tutorial.
Clearly wasn't. She is a cutie. It's true. Yeah, I can see that's. Isn't there just like a category for people just sort of hanging out? In the file, click here. Kind of like the red shadow, kind of nice. It's a little too intense. The shadows. Oh, I don't know. That's a good question. I was doing some of these just because I thought they'd be a little bit easier for people to look at. They definitely go better for posting online. You wait long enough, they'll be back in season. That's a nice big shift there. I don't know, I think it's a good time to be Halloween time all the time. There's a whole tutorial and stuff. There's a few ways to do it. You can actually, there's a program you can paint in 3D, but I can't remember the name of it off the top of my head. It's like Affinity Photo or something like that. And you can actually just paint right in the program with that. So, I saw someone else did it in 3D coat, which would also work. think we might be back up. I'm almost done. I kind of want to do Paisanos. You want anyone to go with? Huh? Do you want anyone to go with? Kind of want. I'm going to use this tool really quick for. Yeah, they just had an update, didn't they, recently? I haven't installed the update yet, though. It's pretty sweet, though. Well, I think that might be it. I'm gonna put a few more little dots in here. The spiral? Ooh. Connected dots, that one sounds good. I don't know if I've used that one yet, or if it's in my version. Let's see. Oh my god, that's so nice. That's awesome. Striker! Striker, I'm about to leave! Yeah, that's true. I'm a late streamer. For you. Specifically. Five something? Oh, I've been streaming for, oh my god, I've been streaming a long time. Oh my god. But yeah. I think I'm actually done. Do the actions. Crisp it up a bit. Oh, you didn't notification it show? I'm sorry. Yeah, maybe you gotta notify on YouTube. Well, let's see how this looks flipped really quick. I like it better the other way. Thanks a lot, everybody. I really appreciate it. Pizza, pizza, pizza! Have a good night. Ooh, wait, I want to add one more thing because when I was taking my photo, it looked really cool. Now I've got to add it. It was just like a mess up on the photo.
this looks, let's see. Secret final touches. Don't tell anybody. Know if I can replicate them. They look so cool on the. It's basically just my screen getting reflections, but I really like them. Yeah, this look really cool. I'm just gonna put them right in the painting. Time in over here just a little bit. $7K, that sounds like a lot. Okay. Now I'm done for reals. Okay. Bye, everybody. Thanks for stopping by.
Bye.